It's a really weird mix of trying to really connect to people, but at the same time to just be not there at all.
We are dressed up exactly the same, with the same t-shirt. We have the same belt, the same jeans, the same shoes.
You're both in sync with each other, kind of psychic.
Absolutely.
Hey everybody, good morning, or more or less good afternoon. It's about 12:30 on Saturday, and I am getting my day started. I just had some breakfast. Day one of Oceaga was a total success. We managed to score 3 interviews, and today is a lot more up in the air. I've called and emailed a few people about getting interviews, and nothing is confirmed really, except for Feist. So we will be talking to Leslie Feist later in the evening. And other than that, the Arkells are playing today, the Sheepdogs are playing today, some good Canadian bands. Snoop Lion is closing out the evening. I got high hopes. It's gonna be a hot one. We're gonna head out right now. Day 2, Oceaga. Look at the view of the city over there, because we are on an island, people, and it's effing hot today. There is no wind, so it's just still and sweaty, and it's making it real hard to do any work, let me tell you. But we're gonna try. I think we should go out there into the masses, because I haven't yet experienced what the music fans are experiencing, so let's go. You are the sweatiest person I've seen so far.
You know, sweatiest person and the person who's been probably drinking the least. The adrenaline and the happiness will get you feeling to the point of your inner ecstasy. So you gotta just feel that and you'll never need a thing other than that in your life.
Oh, I like that. Thank you for that piece of advice. I'm gonna use it all day. Okay. Bye-bye. Don't touch me, I'm really sweaty.
Oceaga 2012.
You have to keep cool by taking your clothes off.
Yeah.
Right?
I have to take my clothes off.
Are you still hot with just your shirt off?
Yeah, I'm okay like that. Yeah.
Make sure he's not gonna get burnt. Put some oil on him.
I don't speak English.
You do? You're speaking English right now?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, put some oil on you.
Forgot that area right there.
Yeah.
I can help you because this is just a mess. We're here to help everyone this weekend. Much music is. It's very greasy, this is happening. This is what we need. Hit me. Ah! It's gonna take you an hour to fill.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's all you get here. This is a good idea. Run down your festival like guide, your tips. What do we need to know?
Keep hydrated, sunshades, and a hat. Very important.
Get here early.
I should put my feet in. Maybe I'll hang with you for a minute. So here's the only refuge on the whole grounds. This is great, eh?
What do we do about ourselves?
I don't know, my microphone's getting wet. I don't know if that's an issue. Is that an issue? I don't think this is good for the electronic equipment. Alright, you wanna take a little ride and show me around? Or I'll show you around. I don't know what makes
sense. Yeah, I just got here, so you
don't know what's going on, right? Okay, you get in first here. So you just got here. Where'd you come from?
We were in town last night. We had a big old night in Montreal. We went out to some bars, so we slept in this morning.
Now, I couldn't help but notice that you guys were tweeting some do's and don'ts of Oceaga or of festivals, and I would like you to share, and you can even go into as much detail as you want, because I think, you know, we've seen a lot of things so far. It's only been a day and a half.
Do's, we wrote tank tops, because it's going to be really hot. Tank tops with sunscreen. Don'ts, we put bras, because Montreal is a pretty liberal, beautiful city, and you know, one weekend out of the year, you probably don't need to wear a bra.
What else should we know?
Finding shade is important. There's a lot of standing around at these festivals. Yeah. You can really wipe yourself out by like 2 in the afternoon if you're not careful about it. Staying hydrated, I think those are the most important things.
Get on with others at these festivals.
For us, the trick is not to be too much of a fanboy. Last time we played Oceaga, the Vampire Weekend guys were sitting like at the table over from us in catering, and so we got pretty nervous there. We didn't say anything, but we were pretty close to going up to them and starting to blabber on about their music. And but so you can't really do that. That's not good form.
So because the chariot has stopped, does that mean the interview stops now? That's our time?
Is that it?
Artist catering is the big deal here at Oceaga. Everyone's like, you better try and get into artist catering. The food's amazing. And the reason it's amazing is because Chuck Hughes from the Food Network and the show Chuck's Day Off is the caterer, is the chef here. So how amazing is that? Like 6-star food on the menu. We're going to find out what's for dinner tonight. What's for lunch?
So basically, what's not for lunch? We open pretty much at 8 o'clock in the morning, and everything starts from there and goes up until probably 8 or 9 or 10 at night. So we're gonna have chickens on there, all kinds of turkey drumsticks, ribs, beef ribs, salads, corn on the cob, raw bar, oysters. Giant paella dish, that's gonna start soon. Tacos, poutine, obviously, of every flavor. Fresh pasta, music, food, art. There's pretty much everything that you want to do on a summer day is all happening here.
How many years have you done the catering at Oceaga?
Number 3, yeah.
Why do you keep coming here? Because everyone talks about it, like this is infamous.
I'll be honest, it's a mix of pleasure and pain, and you know, it's 2 weeks of insane, non-stop cooking, but it's the place to be. So it's not very many places you go and you get to be on an island like this and just eat great food and hear good music. We have a lot of vegan requests, so everybody gets their own plant. So for you to enjoy, yeah, there you go, cheers. It's, is that good? Can I be honest about Snoop? I've got something special prepared, I'm not gonna lie. I found a piece of parsley in the brownies. Snoop, don't say anything.
Hi. Isn't this beautiful?
It's so beautiful.
It's so beautiful.
I didn't know this was right here. I've been right there all day.
We didn't really know either. They scoped it out. Do you want to come this way?
Yeah, sure.
Hi.
What's your name?
Lauren
Leslie.
Yes.
Hi, everyone.
Hi. Well, you look lovely, all festival ready.
Thank you. Yeah, you need a hat.
Do you know much about your celebrity chef who's back there, Chuck Hughes?
Well, now I want to because I can't. I mean, we played a lot of festivals this summer and there's been nothing that. There's been some that come close with that same amount of effort, but this is just next level. I mean, we usually feel a little bit second-class citizen eating off paper plates and stuff, but this has been so beautiful.
With those bittersweet melodies, like a sweet memory.
We've played a number of festivals, and you said you need a hat. Are there other, like, do's, don'ts, must-haves that you need to do at a festival?
Well, I have a different experience than most people because not everyone gets, you know, a Winnebago with some vitamin water and carrot sticks in it, you know? So that's a bit of a shortcut. I kind of have a built-in ease and escape hatch to be cool, but I would say sunscreen, water, you know.
How come you never go there? How come I'm so alone there?
So having played a lot of festivals and been part of them, do you have a best festival story ever?
I saw an old friend the other day who I hadn't seen since I was maybe 19 or something. And she had pictures from a day that we went to Infest 93 or 94. It was in Calgary. And my band won a Battle of the Bands at my high school. And then we won the kind of citywide Battle of the Bands. And then our prize was to play at this festival. And when I think back now, my first show, it was Bad Brains, the Ramones. And it was 3 days long, and we camped, and it was my first gig, basically, as well. And she showed me pictures from that weekend, and I don't have any pictures of my own from that weekend. So I would say the first festival was the crazy experience that I think most people look for at a festival, where you're just give yourself over to the weekend, you know?
Each other.
stage? Like, do you get into a different form?
I hadn't decided.
I mean, I like this. I'm just wondering if you kind of bring another... No, I'm just wondering if you bring another thing to Feist, like, live at the festival, you know?
I guess I don't know. I play it by ear. I have a wardrobe case filled with all sorts of stuff. It's like a little shop, and I just shop through it and decide. So we'll see. I don't know.
However you feel. Well, I can't wait to see you. I think it's going to be gorgeous. It's going to be right near sunset.
Thank you. I know. Yeah, it's going to be a good night. Thanks
nice
a lot.
Thank you for coming. What was really the rock star moment for you when it clicked and you're like, wow, look at what we're doing?
That guy walking in front of the
camera. Yeah, that's how we knew.
What are you guys eating?
We bought it from the ice cream stand.
I am eating pizza cones.
Rosé penne.
Pizza and poutine and Red Bull. A lot of booze.